Hello, this is Cristina Timofte from Technical Support from Pix4D, and today I'm going to show you how to edit the point cloud. You can edit your point cloud if you want to remove noise, to remove features, or to classify points into groups. To do so, you first need to generate the point cloud, and this means that you need to complete the step 2 of processing. After you generate it, you can load it from the left sidebar here. In my case, it's already loaded, but you can simply check the box here, point clouds. After I load it, I can unselect cameras, rays, and tie points, as this is going to give me a better visualization of the densified point cloud. Once I decided on the area that I want to clean or I want to remove features from, in my case here is the conveyor belt here. We can see that I have some noise in this area. I can activate the editing mode, and to do so I will click edit densified point cloud here. Now I can see that I'm in the editing mode, so I can start to select points. To select points, I need to draw a polygon along them. And to draw a polygon, I need to left click around the points. We can see now that I'm drawing a polygon by left clicking. And once I finished, I can right click. When I right click, my points will be highlighted in red. That means that they are selected. But if I look at this from a different angle, I can see that not only the points here are selected, but also the one behind my polygon. This means that whatever action I take from now on, these points will be considered as well. So as I don't want this, I would want to clear my selection. So I go to the toolbar here and press click clear selection, and I want to start it again. I can start again and carefully select only the points what I want, but to make my life easier, I can use a clipping box. So I can activate the clipping box by edit clipping box here. And we can see that in my case, I already have adjusted a bit my clipping box. But there is still some room to improve. So I really want to bring my clipping box as close as possible to my conveyor belt, and to do so I click and drag along the box. Once I'm happy, I click here clip point cloud. Now I see that only the area within my clipping box you can visualize only the area within your clipping box. I will unload the clipping box, and now I will start to select again my points as I have a better visualization. So I start again to draw polygons. So I can see now that only the points that I wanted to select are selected. So we can continue like this for all the points that we want to remove, or we want to classify them in another group. And once I selected all the points, I can assign them to a different group, as I said. To do so, I go again in the toolbar here, and I can see unclassified. This means that in this point, all your points are assigned to this group. But if I activate the list, I can see that I have another groups, deleted, terrain, objects. I can even create a new group. Now, if I want to remove the points, I will select this special group. I would say deleted. I assign my points to the group, and now, if I regenerate the DSM and the orthomosaic, this means that if I rerun step 3 or I regenerate my mesh, these points are not going to be included in my results. If I don't want to delete the points, but I want to assign them to a group, let's say in our case, belt group, belt conveyor, I create a new point group, I name it belt in our case. Okay, I make sure that the group is selected, and I assign the points. Now, once I finish to edit, I unactivate the editing mode, and I can export my point groups by going to point clouds, right clicking on my point cloud and say export point cloud. I want to save my changes, and now I can see that I can select which group to export. I can export all of them, or in my case, I can export only the belt. I can choose the format that I want to export it, and that's it. I press OK, and now the exporting has been finished. That's all that I wanted to show you on how to edit the point cloud. I hope that you find it useful, and see you in the next video.